Web, day two of our special Cannes Fiddy blogisodes, brings something of a tradition. The time when I talk to our kangaroo, Mr. Damo Wise, for his tips. Now, Damo, last year you tipped a white ribbon to win the Palme d'Or on the very first day, and you were right. So what's your tip this year?
Well, I'm looking at the list now, and I think if I was a betting man, I might put some money on Abbas Kiarostami. He's a big favourite at the festival here. His leading lady is Juliette Binoche, who's French royalty. She's the public face of the festival this year, so he's a safe bet. But will he play well with Tim Burton, who's the head of the jury this year? So I'm thinking, well, what will Tim go for? Will he go for Mike Lee? Rhubarb, blah, blah, subtitles, blah, blah, world cinema, blah, 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 rhubarb, rhubarb, pretentious, blah, 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 boring, blah, blah, stuffy Doug Liman.
Oh, Doug Liman, eh? He directed The Bourne Identity, Mr. and Mrs. Smith, Swingers. Brilliant. What's he got in the festival?
Well, he's got a film here called Fair Game. It's about a CIA operative whose cover was blown in the run-up to the Iraq War. And
wow.
She's played by Naomi Watts, and her husband's played by Sean Penn. Yeah. So, you know, it's the only Hollywood movie, and it could be in for some acting awards because, you know, with Naomi Watts, you support Sean Penn, the spark's going to fly. A lot of chemistry, a very heavyweight couple there.
Fantastic. Thanks a lot to our kangaroo, Mr. Damon Wise. Now, from one Empire tradition to another, blah, 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 comic book movies, blah, 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 Steven Gerrard, blah, 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 lightsabers, blah, 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 Aunt Beru, blah, 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 posters.
Oh, posters. You can go around and look at the posters like you do every year.
I just said that.
I knew that.
I'm outside the Carlton Hotel, and behind me is a giant display for the Jack Black comedy Gulliver's Travels, which, as you can see, is an actual 3D. Or should I say, actual tenacious 3D. That's a good joke. That's a good joke. Magnificent display there for Wall Street. Money Never Sleeps is the subtitle of Oliver Stone's sequel. Clearly, it's come to the right place. Because nothing sleeps in Canada. What? Salt is a film shrouded in mystery. Who is Salt? Asks the poster. Angelina Jolie, it answers just seconds later. Mystery solved. That was easy. The Last Airbender in 3D. Like all M. Night Shyamalan films, this one also has a twist. Might actually be good. Didn't see that one coming. This wonderful poster for one of our current cover movies, The A-Team, finally proves one of Hollywood's longest-standing rumours. Liam Neeson does indeed have a massive weapon. You know, the thing I like most about this rather lovely understated poster for The Karate Kid is the director's name, Harold Svart. Now, of course, Hilary Swank was the next Karate Kid, so if your name is Jeff Schminge, get ready for stardom, because this franchise is going to come calling. Willis! Fox! Kane! Lynch! Crane. God, that guy from Coronation Street's really let himself go. Poster there for the Chronicles of Narnia, the Voyage of the Dawn Treader. The tagline reads, Return to the Magic, which begs the question, when were we ever there? If you've waited all your life to see Chiman Hunsu and Kevin Bacon in a movie together, well, you're probably mad. But hey, good news! This logo for Simon Pegg's new film solves one long-standing debate. Was it Burke and Hare or Burke ampersand Hare? Actually, that looks like an 8. There's two L's in Russell. Look, he's even telling you, two! The tagline for Gulliver's Travels, something big is going down, works in three levels. Gulliver is big and he's going down. To the Lilliputians, he's big and he's going down. Also, he's a massive fan of cunnilingus. When you directed Tango and Cash, there's really only one place to go, and that place is apparently the Nutcracker in 3D. Andre, why are you wasting your time with this children's 3D nonsense when you could be directing Tango and Cash 2, man? I'm not saying this row of posters is a kiss of death for movies, but the last two Al Pacino films to be displayed here were 88 Minutes and Righteous Kill. So actually, you know what? I am saying this row of posters is a kiss of death for movies.
I got three dead movies on the sidewalk, Justine. I'm sorry if the goddamn box office got undercooked.
Well, that's it for this year's poster roundup. The pickings may have seemed a little thin in the ground, but then you could say the same about the big stars and the big movies at this year's festival. Mind you, they don't come much bigger than Russell Crowe and Robin Hood, Behind me is the party for the opening night film here at the Majestic Beach. I've got my ticket. Going in now. See you tomorrow for more film-related fun. Bye. Why is Jamie Foxx playing me in a movie? Nobody approached me for the rights to my life.